Hello everyone, welcome to Repentino. Now this video is going to be about SSC CHSL Tier 1 2017 cutoff, the answer key for which has been released by the commission. Of course, this was a tentative answer key, but it will give you a fair idea about the range of your marks. Now I hope you all have checked your answer keys, and those of you who have not been able to do so will have to wait till June 15th. When the final result of CHSL will be announced. Now here we are going to have an estimation of the cutoff as well as the safe score. This is for candidates to know what should be their level of preparation for Tier 2, which is a descriptive paper, and the third level, that is typing test. For CHSL. Of course, you have to be good at typing, but what marks should you get in CHSL to be able to start your preparation for descriptive, and that too with confidence, so that in the final merit list you see your name. So let us do a little bit of analysis and try to find out the expected cutoffs. Now, I'm sure there must be a lot of anticipation for the result and the cutoff. So here we are going to do a bit of analysis. Also, we are going to see the past trends, and finally, we'll have our expected cutoff for this year, that is 2017, which depends on a lot of factors that we are going to talk about. But when we talk about trends, one thing that has been observed is that the number of candidates has been increasing every year, and this time approximately 26 lakh people appeared for CHSL exam that was conducted from 4th March to 28th March. Now for this exam, the marks are already out, and what everybody is waiting for is the final result, which they said will be released on 15th June. Now let us observe a few more things when we talk about the trend here. Let us talk, for example, about 2016. The cutoff for general was 127.5, that for OBC was 120, 108 for SC and 99 for ST. Now talking about the year 2017, that is this year, than the year 2016, talking about the paper itself, the candidates found the paper to be of similar difficulty level or maybe slightly easier than last year. In fact, only GK part was a bit tough, which actually depends from student to student. But overall, the paper was almost of the same level. But what can affect the cutoff is going to be number of vacancies, which has gone down from 6,709 in 2016 to 3,259 in 2017. But this is not going to affect the cutoff for Tier 1 much, because we have Tier 2 and Tier 3 also, and here they're going to release more students out. For Tier 2, they're going to call almost the same number of students that they called last year, and so this is not going to be a big deciding factor. As I said, the difficulty level was almost the same. Now the competition level is increasing because the number of vacancies are decreasing, as you can see. Also, the number of candidates appearing for exam is increasing every year because people from diverse background are coming up to take this exam. Earlier, maybe 12th pass students, BSc and BComs, those who are also trying for CGL used to appear for CHSL, but that is not the case now. Even students from BTech are appearing for this exam, that is CHSL, due to the high level of competition in almost every field. Now here we are going to do a small tabular analysis. Now as you can see by this graph, no doubt overall cutoff is increasing every year. But if you see that within the categories also, the difference here is getting reduced. As you can see from the graph, the difference between general and OBC for the year 2016 was 7.5, while in 2015 it was 9 and 12 in 2014. That means that the competition within the categories is also increasing. Now, taking all these into consideration, let us see what the expected cutoff can be. Now, why is it that we should be so much concerned about the cutoff from now itself is because the month of June and July is going to be full of exams. Now, some of you must have applied for SBI exam also. So, in the month of June, we have a clerk exam. July, we'll have POs. Also in the July, we have the descriptive paper. Not only that, also between the month of June and July, CGL Tier 3 is expected to be conducted. Now, those of you who are very sure of clearing CGL Tier 2 would have obviously started their preparation for descriptive. And so, of course, their preparation for CHSL descriptive would be going together. But those of you who are not very sure of CGL or those who applied only for CHSL have around 2 months. Because the exam is on July 8th. So around 2 months would be sufficient for preparation of a descriptive. Start noting down all the recent happenings, all the important essays. Start reading and start taking exams, giving mocks. So according to Repentino, taking under consideration all the factors which decide the cutoff, the expected cutoffs are 130 to 135 for general. Since the difference is not going to be so much, it is going to be 125 to 130 for OBC. 110 to 115 in this range for SC and 100 plus, in fact 100 to 105 for ST category. Now those who have got plus 10 from these scores are in the safe side. That means they should not only start preparing very well for descriptive but also for the typing test. And these people can be very sure of having their name in the merit list. Now, why a descriptive paper or tier 2 becomes very important is because, for example, if we take 2016, the cutoffs for tier 1 were as follows: 127.5, 120 for OBC, 108 for SC, and 99 for ST. Now, what happens after tier 2, when the score of tier 1 and tier 2 is taken into consideration, the cutoff was, now I'm taking an example, I'm taking CAG post, data entry operator. In CAG post, the cutoff was 202.5, 194 for OBC, 182.5 for SC, and 172 for ST. Now, if you look here, the difference in the marks is around 75 to 76 marks. Now, this descriptive paper is not going to be like SSC CGL, where one can score 70 to 75. While in CHSL, the average score is around 60. And so, you have to be around 10 marks above the cutoff so as to secure the minimum cutoff after tier 2. And so, these are our expected cutoffs, and plus 10 will be the safe score so that you can happily start preparing for descriptive and typing test. So all the best to all of you from Repentino. Thank you.
If you like the video, please hit the like button, comment and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe for all our future videos.